too red to six, not pages. This ain't on the green on the wizard up. Pocket pockets full of mint leaves. Been smelling like it brushed tea. Say cheese, see the porcelain. Water see deep. Backwoods. Raph dragon on the floor. In it. I'm torching the road in these Gucci flames. Stuck to the pavement, they glued. I'm 2.5 million in the venue and 2,500 a tube. I'm cold like I'm sick with the flu. I cover my face and I'm that's spring summer 2002. Yeah, please don't touch my ride. From the grass, Teddy, with the Teddy. Quick with the hands, ready. Please don't touch my please don't touch my ride. Shirt off, I'm Cam, ready. Dead stock in memory. Please don't pop my tie.
Back now on EA Sports at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Our halftime festivities behind us as we're just about set for the opening kick of the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This one taken from the seven. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Back to throw now on first down. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. They'll set up to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. He'll drop to throw. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
They'll look to throw here. His pass caught at the four. That catch good for eight, but still, it's third and goal now. Defense showing blitz. This offense so far on third down, they've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and goal. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. A great job to hold him to just a yard there. Now it's fourth and goal.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and sneak it here. Try to wedge his way in there. No signal. I don't think he got there. He did it. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in. And the Bucs defense, they'll celebrate the goal line stand. To start the drive to Sims. And now where are they going to mark him here? Well, they say he did get back to the 1-yard line, but that could have easily been 2 points the other way.
Really shouldn't be a surprise. It's going to be hard to move people in this situation. You know they're going to bring the pressure defensively. Because I remember playing in these spots, and my coaches always say, don't be afraid to try and create a safety, too. They're going to bring pressure.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
Let's go!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Throws right side, and that's complete. A nice gain of 21 yards. And he's over 100 yards now after that last catch. Already, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause to stay in that spot. But I've been so impressed with how he's gotten it done. Body control, route running. How about
he? And he lost the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Touchdown, 49ers! George Kittle, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Niners are able to cash in for six.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well organized, well coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Now back to throw, and that is caught for the 2 points. And, of course, on the two-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
Felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? An open receiver, ball's put on him, 2 points for them.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Winston shrugs the tag, and with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series, but the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
The play fake to Sims. Now Winston. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Solomon Thomas in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. Let's take it inside his own 40. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Niners set up well. They take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. He got 29 yards that time. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And the agility got him a few extra before he's taken down right at the 10. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Here we go now. 3-19.
He'll look to throw. That's complete right around the 8. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
He'll look to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. George Kittle, his second touchdown of the game, giving him 12 on the season. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. And this one through the uprights and good. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to 2nd and 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Make it now 3 tackles for a loss in this game, 1 for each quarter.
And for a guy who played defense in college, I can just tell you that he's feeling very satisfied right now by what he's doing. But he's elated because he knows what he's doing is helping his team win the game right now. Making some big-time plays, getting into the offense's backfield, and spilling everything.
They'll get 4 on 2nd down, but it leaves them with 3rd and still 9 to go.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now, because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
And they get 10 yards there and convert on 3rd. First down, here's the run with Martin. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4.
But he was stopped on that play, but he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
Winston, and that is incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And the punt team on now as this one sent away. Just 21 yards on the punt there. And San Francisco gets set to go here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still 3rd quarter, but the ball comes out, and the Buccaneers have it.
ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Second down, Winston. He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. And he's brought down. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you could see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
Third and 11. And some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. From the gun, Winston. And he's got a man. It's the tight end, Howard, complete. A big hit. Knocked down sideways at the 9-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And in a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got him back.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again, to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far. Ready. Watch for the
pass. Now Jameis on second down. And he's gonna go down again. Vic Beasley in there to get him. And that is sack number 15 for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Winston. And this is going to be incomplete.
The effort's always going to be there. Everyone's always going to try and make a catch. But underthrown balls, I think, are the toughest ones to come back and get, because usually your momentum's going in the opposite direction when you're trying to stop, break, and come back and get it.
And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Vic Beasley in there to drop him, and he continues to wreak havoc in offensive backfield. Sack number 16 on the year. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A very solid gain of 27. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the play. They'll set up a throw. And that'll be incomplete. Second down following the incompletion. Back to throw here. Being chased out left. A swing pass caught, and he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the one. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era when we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's
and it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Kyle Juszczyk, his third touchdown now on the year. And the 49ers add on to their lead.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. This will be fielded at the six. With the Bucs offense making their way back out on the field, let's take a look at the playoff picture, Charles, coming into the weekend in the NFC. And with the final fortnight of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games, they're just starting to take enormous importance as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use fortnight.
Hey, you're impressed, don't you?
I am impressed. That means 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
That does.
But how about exactly what you're talking about? Going down the stretch, how much importance is placed on these games? Look, everyone talks about every game's important. When you get to this time of year, maybe that importance gets quadruple. And that's where we are right now, to see who can make their last run, their last push to get into the playoffs.
His throw incomplete.
They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing, timing, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there, threw it behind him. On third down, Winston. Down he goes. The 49ers get there. Ray Armstrong in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And this is going to be incomplete. The Bucs try it on fourth down, but come up empty. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. So a risky, risky move that does not pay off. But Charles, you take it from the defensive perspective, they had to be a little offended there that they even tried to go for it back inside their own 20.
Highly offended. And they took the ball away and gave it to their offense in a great situation. But when you look at this thing in total, when you start taking chances like that, you know what that means? You have to take more chances later, right? When you don't convert, that just means you got to double down on it. So we could see this thing pile up as we go on.
This is caught, and he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. George Kittle with his third touchdown so far, number 13 now on the year. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
This will be fielded at the 8. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over. There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
every now and then I scratch my head when I see the draw play called, especially after a great run the previous play. Keep attacking. Sometimes a draw play develops slowly, and that allows the defense to react.
To throw is Winston. And he is knocked down from the side. So they'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
Well, in the grand scheme of things, it's likely not going to matter much, but at least they get themselves 3 points closer to respectability.
And I don't know that they're going to feel a whole lot better about things because they've clearly been outplayed all game long. But, hey, no reason not to take the points when the opportunity presents itself.
Oh, I think the Bucs got it, and they did. Tampa Bay football. Great job by the kick team there to get the football, but also don't forget about the man that started it, the lonesome kicker himself.
I love that you brought him into it because he doesn't get nearly the attention he deserves. Oftentimes, it's only when it's negative. In this case, he created a positive play for his team.
Jameis to throw it. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Solomon Thomas in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Jackson's got it over the middle. And the 49ers going to take another timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Third and one. Here's Winston. Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. But he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll drop the throw. Flushed out right. Room here to run. And he's going to go out of bounds. He takes this one down shy of the 20. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds. A nice gain of 21 yards.
Go ahead and throw the ball, man. You got the big lead. You got the clock on your side. Obviously, they don't care much about the feelings of the other team, do they?
Well, I was going to say, you better run to the locker room pretty quick after this one.
Well, right now, maybe. They're just looking at it from the fantasy perspective. More points for everyone if they win big.
Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it, lost it there. And it'll be second down.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line, but it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. They almost had it. The big D lineman nearly had an interception. Instead, it falls down incomplete. They'll look to throw on third and goal. Between his ears right now. It's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offensive coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Now a second down throw for Winston. Over the middle to Evans. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Winston on third and two. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Howard. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. To throw, Winston. And that's complete. It's Sims. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
And you know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too. Yeah,
everyone dialed in. Well, and tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle.
Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Akello Witherspoon. There he goes, right side. And into the end zone. A pick six for the 49ers D as they score the touchdown. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
Now a hit and a loose football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line. Now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout. And as the two teams chalk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. That one looks like he'll throw here. And it's caught. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one fielded at the five. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about it.
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Indeed, get him to the line and spike it here to stop the clock. So it's third and long, and defensively, not a real surprise. They're in the dime. Working out of the gun, Winston. Evans has it left side. And he gets this one up just shy of the 35 to the 34. They convert on third with a gain of 22. And he'll indeed get him to the line and spike it here to stop the clock. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. To the air again with Winston. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third.
Ready.
Jameis again. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. Here's Brian Anger now as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Now a High kick, almost a pooch punt. Fielded just inside the 20. So possession goes over here on the punt. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before we hit triple zeros. And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey.
Yeah. Pulling up with the crew.
Oh, my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh, my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh, my goodness.
I would take notes of.